Yes, students, today we shall start the play Twelfth Night, as the introductory chapters are now enough. So, today we shall see the whole of the act first and its five scenes. Let us start with the act first scene first. In the very beginning of the play, we see the Duke plunged into thoughts for Olivia. He is lovelorn, sick in love for Olivia, and he is singing the song. The very first lines of the play are like this: if music be the food of love, play on, give me excess of it, that surfeiting the appetite may sicken and so die. So in this manner he is thinking about Olivia and is very desirous to see her, to meet her. On the other side, Olivia is in deep grief over his brother's demise, over her brother's death. She has taken a vow to cloister herself, to seclude herself from the world outside for 7 whole years. So this first scene is there. On one side, Duke's palace, and the other, Olivia's household. And the second scene, in the second scene, we see that the scene introduces us with Voila, perhaps the heroine of the play. Voila, she is saved from the shipwreck, and at the same time, she had lost her brother Sebastian, and she is also in feeling a sense of loss, perhaps, which makes her anxious to enter the service of the unknown Olivia, who grieves so deeply for the death of her brother. Voila feels a bond of sympathy. Ultimately, we will come to know in the further acts that she doesn't join Olivia's household. Rather, with the captain's help, she decides to enter the service of Orsino. So in the next scenes, that is scene third, we are introduced to Sir Toby Belch. As we have seen in the dramatis personae, Sir Toby Belch, who is by no means sober. Maria and Sir Andrew Elchick, and comic subplot is launched. So we are introduced to Maria, Sir Andrew, and Sir Toby Belch. And there is a comic subplot. Sir Toby is in conversation with Maria. She rebukes him for his loose behavior. Sir Toby, however, is more concerned with making what he can out of Sir Andrew Elchick. And Andrew Elchick, who is a foolish knight, who loiters on in the household under the delusion that he may win the hand of Olivia. So, Sir Andrew Elchick is a loiter, and he loiters in hope to get the hand of Olivia. And proceeding further, scene fourth, we see that Voila, who is now in disguise, and she is under the disguise of Cesario, under the name of Cesario, is now in the service of Orsino. She disguises herself as Cesario, and at Orsino's palace, she is working there, with whom she has fallen in love. At the same time, she has fallen in love with Cesario, but she cannot speak her love. So, A love triangle has been built between Duke. Duke loves Olivia, and Viola, which has been introduced in the very beginning, now at the household of Duke, loves Duke, and Olivia is there. She is secluded. She has secluded herself. So a love triangle has been built. The Duke sends his newfound messenger, which is Viola in the name of Cesario, and he sends his newfound messenger to Olivia. And in the last scene of the first act, we see that Maria reproves the clown for being so long absent from Olivia's house, and she warns that Olivia will rebuke him, and he will have to get her wrath. There is a clash between Feste, the clown, and the Malvolio too. Maria reports the arrival of a young gentleman from the Count Orsino. Olivia meets Viola, who is, again, we are to keep in mind, has disguised herself as Cesario, as a boy. And when Olivia meets Viola in the garb of a boy, she falls in love with Viola, that is Cesario, that is Viola. She falls in love with her, and after the interview, sends Malvolio in pursuit with the ring, which she pretends was left behind. She pretends that the ring that Viola has forgotten or left there. So she sends Malvolio with that ring. So in this first act, so many developments are there, introducing almost every important character of the play Shakespeare has introduced in the very first act, and the development of plot has been there. We have come to know about the love triangle, about the disguisement of Viola as Cesario, and how Olivia has secluded herself, and then she meets with the newfound messenger of Duke, and she falls in love with the same messenger whom she doesn't even know, and she asks her, "What is your parentage?" But he tells that, "I am a gentleman." So it's a very interesting beginning. So you should read out the text and read these notes, and with the second act, all the scenes will be covered in the next chapter. Till then, thank you.